Hey, welcome back for round three. I'm Tom Denby.
Dan Horgan.
So we got a real cool guy matchup here. Mono Blue versus Mono Red. Sean McCary versus Colin McCarthy.
Yep. McCary McCarthy.
So this, I don't honestly know who's favored in this matchup. It's kind of just two ships walking past each other.
Yeah, essentially it's who's going to go faster, right?
Right. Sonic the Hedgehog got to go fast. So, this is really not my kind of magic.
Yeah, not mine either. Gonna pitch that. That was zero lands for Sean.
What is that card?
Which one?
The old card.
I didn't see it.
Maybe they were mountains.
Could have been.
It looks like he's keeping.
Yeah, I did not see what it was.
Sean, get him out to six.
Yeah.
Colin kept it. I think they were mountains. I think they were just old art, white bordered mountains.
I guess we'll see, won't we?
Mm-hmm.
See what we got for six. There's a land there. That looks like a...
Lands and dudes, yep. We're good.
We keep it on nice top. Too.
Yeah, he does. I like those islands.
I think those might be shocks.
Yeah, they might be shocks. Because he has full art mountains. I don't know, I couldn't tell.
I don't know, I guess we'll see.
Sean just going to play a second island and pass. Colin going to combat. I'm sure we're just going to see Sean and flash in this Merfolk Trickster. If they are shocks, they'll get fired off here. One of them will at least.
Yep.
And that's what they are, they're shocks. Get two, going to get in for one.
Yeah, so I'm surprised he didn't cast that before attacks are declared. Because it taps it, right?
Well, he wanted to try and eat it.
I guess, yeah. But, I mean, you're playing against a burn deck.
If you can eat the creature for free, you do it. Colin didn't even play a second land, so he wasn't threatening. Shock,
okay,
shock.
Yeah.
So, totally fine. Sean just going to play a Mistcloak Herald and pass the turn. No third land.
Dive down.
Dive it down against this shock.
Okay, he'll block it.
Get a free block in, yep.
It's like it doesn't die, it gets plus 0, plus 3. He's like, oh, that's a good card.
Well, it's a 2-2, though, so it's fine. It's a free attack because the Mistcloak Herald can't be blocked anyway.
Right.
You gotta keep him honest, basically, right?
Yeah, so we see a Curious Obsession, and he just drew a Spell Pierce, too.
That's really good. Both players are missing land drops, so Spell Pierce is going to act like a hard counter to whatever burn spell Colin tries to hit this Mistcloak Herald with.
Correct.
He's already used two shocks too, so the likelihood of having a third one mana interactive spell,
right,
even if Sean were to hit his third land, is lower. Well, saying that, he's got a couple of Wizard's Lightnings in his hand, which are one mana spells here.
Does he have? I think he just has one.
He too has a Lava Runner. Is it just one? Okay.
So he's going to play a Light Up the Stage, and it's going to get Spell Pierced.
Yeah, pretty quick.
And then we'll probably see response Wizard's Lightning, or no, I guess not.
Ooh, that seems like a mistake.
Yeah, you don't want him drawing cards off this.
Yeah. You really can't let him connect again, especially when he's tapped out.
Correct. Now he just hit that third land off
there. I'm going to play a Tempest Djinn. So he did tap out for that, but he's totally fine tapping out because it's going to be really hard for Colin to deal with this Tempest Djinn.
Right. And yeah, you just never block with it. There's no reason.
Right, the Tempest Djinn's gonna outraise everything pretty much.
Mm-hmm. He has to have double burn spell for it. Which
yeah.
He does, right?
Which yeah,
no,
but even if Colin casts two burn spells targeting the Tempest Djinn, and they both resolve,
mm-hmm,
Sean's totally fine with that. He's got two Wizard's retorts in his hand,
right,
so they're never resolving though.
I would have liked him to come in with the Getu Lava Runner and see if he blocks with the Tempest Djinn, because then you could just burn it.
Yeah.
Right?
I agree with that. Colin gonna check out the attacking Mistcloak Herald. Check out, make sure he knows what it does. See, he's really gonna get punished for not removing this Curious Obsession to Mistcloak Herald, because he's gonna get retorted here pretty hard.
Right.
Doesn't have a wizard,
oh,
so
yeah,
it's full price. Gonna get in for two, draw another card. Draws a Spell Pierce there. So that Spell Pierce, you know, really, really good against this Mono Red deck.
Right, yeah. Like, really good.
I feel, honestly, looking at the matchup just on paper here, Mono Blue's probably favored. Spell Pierce, so good against them. Same thing with just Wizard's Retort. Being able to counter two or three spells in a aggro matchup, gonna just carry you to victory.
Right, yeah. And also, you're pretty quick in Mono Blue, so you're able to not let them go to the late game.
Right. And cards like Spell Pierce, like I was saying, they're not typically as good in a format like Standard. Right. But in this matchup, they really shine. And if your Spell Pierces are good, your deck is really good in the matchup. Does that make sense?
Right, yeah. No, I know what you're saying. We've seen another Miscloak Herald.
I wanted to see Colin main phase to the Risk Factor in his hand with the 3 mana from the Runaway Steamkin. Just unload the damage, right?
Right.
It's not getting any better.
Correct, yeah. No, I know what you're saying. Sorry, I'm just trying to see if he was attacking with this Tempest Djinn or not.
I think he's content to leave it back. This Curious Obsession on the Miscloaked Herald is going to be good enough to win him this game. If he can just block the... there's the fourth island, too.
So that's really good.
Yeah.
That's a 4-4.
He's going to be able to counter pretty much everything from now on. Upkeep, he's going to tap. So this is going to be innocuous because I don't think Colin really understands that his Runaway Steamkin might not be able to remove mana now. And that's the big thing. This Mono Red deck, in Standard at least, yeah, it's really low to the ground, but it's mana hungry.
He had to remove him in response because it loses abilities, right?
Correct. He's not going to be able to do it twice, is basically. And now it's not going to get a counter from that either. So he's losing value.
Right, so if he did that, cast the Risk Factor.
Right, that's what I'm getting at. And now he's a turn behind on the damage race. If he had done it last turn, he would have been able to jumpstart the Risk Factor this turn with that extra mountain he just drew.
Right. Yeah, he's so, drew the fifth land, so that's...
Right, what's the fifth land doing for you?
I'm talking about Sean.
Colin did too.
Land. Yeah, he just drew his fifth land to make this Tempest Djinn a 5-5.
Well, I was going to say, islands are really good for Sean because they let him cast two spells in a turn. They make the Tempest Djinn bigger. Extra mountains are only fodder for this Risk Factor. He shouldn't have played the mountain, honestly. You have basically infinite mana with these Runaway Steamkins, too, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't like playing the mountain. I believe so. And he's got an op, too. He really just wants to find more Wizard's Retorts. That's all he needs.
Yep. Another op.
Just cast it. Maybe not. Maybe leave up all your mana for interaction.
Or play Miscloaked.
Oh, that's a Terramander, though.
Oh, the Terramander. No.
Yeah, you play that because you have 1, 2, 3, 4... 5 instants and sorceries in your graveyard, so...
3 mana.
3 mana, you can do it now. Or if you cast an opt, it'll be 2 mana.
Yep.
So, let's see, if he can get him with an opt and a Spell Pierce, get full value, and then 1 mana this Terramander, I would be real happy.
And then Sean's probably just gonna take damage here, right?
He's gonna opt in response.
Okay.
Because keep in mind, like, every spell he casts is free for the Terramander. For the Adapt, I mean.
Right.
So, I kind of want to see...
I think he just drew a Wizard's Retort.
No, he drew a Curious Obsession.
Oh, okay.
I want to see him fire off this Spell Pierce at it. Oh, and yeah, he missed his trigger there. There it goes. I don't know, maybe. Maybe, did he take the 4? Yeah, he did. Spell Pierce isn't getting better. Oh, yeah, he's just going to scoop him up.
Yeah.
He knew he was dead.
Right.
Mono Blue does actually feel pretty heavily favored, just seeing how it played out. Sean was on a mull to 6. Colin's hand was pretty decent, and Sean just ran him over.
Right, yeah. Like, that's kind of how this deck works, right? Against Mono Red. Mono Red doesn't really have many ways to deal with Tempest Djinn.
Right.
Man, these guys are just going through their phone and stuff, like... you doing?
Ignorant. You on camera.
Ignorant.
Maybe he's looking at his sideboard guide. How do I board for Mono Red? You remove these 4 and you put these 4. That almost feels to me like what he's looking at.
Yeah.
Is that legal?
It is not, if that is the case. Sean, if you're watching this, let us know what you're doing. Because even if
he is, clearly he's not. He would never say, "Oh yeah,
I mean,
I was cheating on camera."
I mean,
I'm not sure. That's kind of what it looks like he's doing, though.
I mean, technically, you aren't allowed to use cameras or phones during a match at all. But this isn't competitive RL, so I don't care.
Because, I text and stuff during matchups at right. F&M and whatnot. Yeah. I don't know if I'm cool with it. That's what he's doing, though. Kind of looks like it.
Yeah, I have no idea what this
is. Look at that. It looks like a deck list, doesn't it?
Maybe.
I'm not sure. I'm not accusing Sean of anything. And right. again, it's F&M. Who gives right. a shit? Yeah. Nobody cares.
I know, when I go to, Grand Prix and stuff, I write down what I board. Board in and board out and what I'm playing against. Just so for future reference, in the game, I can technically go back to it because I wrote it down.
Right.
Right?
I do the same thing at competitive REL, and when yeah. I'm getting ready for competitive REL, I have, lists of stuff that I board in and out mm-hmm. for certain matchups. I would never pull out my phone and do that.
Right. You know, I write it on the back of my sheet of what I write, what I board in, when I'm on the play, when I'm on the draw, what I'm playing against, when I'm boarding in, what I'm boarding out, just so I have reference to go back to. And also, so afterwards I can be like, well, what did you guys think about how I boarded? Let's say I make day two, right?
Right.
I can go back to the hotel with my friends and go, what do you guys think of how I boarded?
Here's some post-game analysis. Right.
You know, and then my friends can be like, well, I don't think you really need to bring this card in because it's not good against them.
Right.
You know, maybe I'm boarding in too many cards, boarding in not enough cards.
Right. You know, you got to get it optimal in that regard. No, I get where you're coming from. And again, I'm not accusing Sean of anything. It's just, it either looked like the phone looked like it had a deck list or a pizza menu. really, maybe he was looking at what he's getting for dinner afterwards. I know I'm looking forward to what I'm eating after I leave here. Right. I'm going to get some Chinese food, my man. So I'm just sitting here.
Where are you getting Chinese food at?
This place near my house called Moe's.
Oh, I know Moe's.
Moe's Chinese Kitchen?
Yeah, there's one in New Lenox.
I love that place.
Their orange chicken is really good.
I really like their sushi.
Yeah, I'm not a big fan of fish in general, so...
I'm not a big fan of anything that's not shellfish. I like
that's
crab.
That's not selfish?
It's pretty selfish to the shellfish themselves because yeah. I'm eating them.
Yeah, but...
But I am the top of the food chain, so I am human, and I'm going to eat them. Yeah, I wouldn't eat... Well, here's the thing. I can eat a shark. I bet if you...
You cannot eat too much of a shark, though. You will die.
Fair enough. But you know what? If I were to get into the water, knowing that, hey, I need to fight a shark to survive.
Oh,
I'm getting into the water prepared. I'm going to get, a torpedo gun.
A torpedo gun?
Yeah. Hey, don't worry about
where... You mean a submarine?
No, I mean a torpedo gun.
Okay, I don't know how you're going to carry that around.
Don't worry about it, okay? If I'm going to fight a shark, I need some heavy artillery.
Okay. Right, you know, if I'm going to...
Maybe I'll just bring a harpoon.
If I'm going to fight a shark, I'm honestly just going to bring a bigger shark.
There. Is Sean here on a mulligan? Yeah. Oof.
Colin is.
Colin, yeah. I meant the mono red.
Yeah, no, his hand was 7 red spells, no lands.
So let me say this, too, about mulligans in this matchup. Mono blue mulligans, surprisingly well.
Yeah, they have draw spells.
They have draw spells. All their stuff, is the same.
Some of his deck is upside down.
And it makes me tilted.
Not only that, but it is illegal.
Mono red
can get a
mulligans possible. Horribly, yeah.
Oh, God,
and every time
5.
Yeah, mono red's a count to 20.
Yeah.
And every card you lose in mono red is less cards that you can use to count
yeah.
to 20.
Yeah, it's not like the old mono red decks where they just mulligan really well. You could keep a 5 lander and be you can keep a 5 mulligan to 5 and be fine.
Right,
you had
Courier.
Right,
and
you had even before that, when you had, Monastery Swift Spear and stuff.
Uh-huh.
Because you had fetch lands and, even though, you were playing mono red, some of them just played 4 fetch lands to shuffle their deck.
Right.
Right?
To shuffle their deck and thin it. Ugh.
Oh, my God.
Well, you keep it.
You have to, right?
You got
you have
spells,
lands,
you got lands, he's got no creatures, no repeatable source of damage. Oh, man, that's a light up the stage, I think, right?
Yes, I believe so.
That's honestly pretty good here. Yeah, I thought it was a skewer the critics at first, but then it's a light up the stage. If it gets spell pierced, okay. I was gonna say spell pierce would be
so chain whirler and banefire.
That's actually the two worst things he could have possibly seen off that light up the stage.
Yeah,
it's basically he just exiled the top 2 cards of his deck.
Yes, he did. Unless he can cast this Chain Ruler.
I was going to say, the Banefire is for sure not getting cast unless Sean just, like, chimps out a creature. You know what I mean?
Right.
Throws the creature into the Banefire Grinder. If Colin finds a third land...
There it is.
Okay, just play the Chain Whirler.
Yep. And then exile that Banefire.
I'm surprised to see Banefire in on us. Well, maybe not. There's a lot of counter spells out of Sean. Still kind of surprised to see it, to be honest. Seems expensive for the matchup.
Well, I mean, if he Banefired at the end of if he drew Banefire at the end of that last game, he just won.
That's true.
Okay, so he flashes in Merfolk Trickster.
Yeah, taps it down. Sean's hand is stacked here. Siren Storm Tamer negate. I think there's a Tempest Djinn in there. Couple other cards that are still spells. Wizard's Lightning here from Colin. Gonna get eaten with a negate.
Still gonna
see
the negate here?
Yeah.
Or does he care? I don't think he cares. Yeah.
Oh, is it targeting the Trickster? Okay, yeah, he doesn't care. I thought it was going upstairs. Which, I'm honestly surprised it didn't go upstairs.
Trickster, again.
You're winning in combat, you know?
Right.
You're not going to win the creature game here if you're fighting over the creatures.
Tempest Djinn.
Yeah. I mean, having said all that, your hand's still very bad.
He's going to Wizard's Lightning the Trickster again? He's like, wait, me? Ooh, okay. Fine. He's like, I'm not taking damage to the face, right?
So, Colin here's not got the worst. He's got Runaway Steamkin and Flame of Keld.
Yeah, play that, and then play the Flame of Keld.
So, you're really, really desperate for this Flame of Keld to just hit two spells and then draw a spell for turn next turn.
Yeah.
That's really the... I mean, Sean has five spells in his hand, and it's so... Even if it is three spells, like, Colin's just getting buried here. You know, he's about to Curious Obsession up this Tempest Djinn. He's got two, maybe three counter spells in his hand. This game feels like it's about over.
I concur.
Colin's going to lose the damage race.
Five damage here.
Yeah. I mean, Sean's at 17, and Colin is still presenting five damage a turn, but he can...
Oh, and now he can protect it with Storm Chaser, too.
Yeah.
Like, that's just...
That Storm... That Tempest Djinn's basically, like, essentially
a
3-turn. Oh,
that's so bad for Colin.
He drew two mountains and a lightning strike.
That's so bad.
Rip.
Oh, that's rough.
Ripping pepperonis, man.
Ripperoni.
In pepperoni.
I don't even think you need a block.
No, I like the block. You have a lot of protection here. You just want to keep your life total high enough to win the race. That's really all you need to do. Really, if you're Sean, the best things you can draw here are just lands.
Yeah, islands.
Islands. It lets you play more than one spell a turn. It grows this Tempest Djinn, so...
Right.
I really like just keeping your life total high, chumping your way through this Goblin Chain Whirler. Because keep in mind, Sean doesn't know what's in Colin's hand. He might think Colin is sitting on three burn spells, getting ready for this Claim of Kel
to
go off.
But I don't think you block on that last turn, because...
That's interesting to me.
I don't think it is.
Oh, no, it took the abilities off. That's right, that's right. I was talking about it earlier, but I was just like, why did he only tap the thing, you know?
Right.
I don't know, I think you get rid of the Chain Whirler.
Four damage...
That's five damage to it.
I thought they just deal one extra.
They deal two extra with Flame of Keld.
Okay.
So dive down, gonna protect it.
We'll see. Get two Lava Runner.
Yep. That's really bad. This game is just done. Sorry, Colin. Just trade with the Gitu, yeah. Totally fine. Take your five, take your beats. You're so far ahead in the damage race here.
Right. And he has so much protection.
Right, that's the thing, is Tempest Djinn's never leaving the board.
Right, but what I was saying earlier is, by not blocking the Chain Whirler the last turn, he could have just held the Storm Chaser to block this turn and taken none with the extra damage.
Well, he might be thinking he's getting burned out is the point.
I guess.
Like, that's where his logic comes from, is I have a Merfolk Trickster...
Right.
I have to just keep my life total as high as possible. I agree with the block. I think it was a good block, not knowing what's in Colin's hands with this Flame of Keld about to go off, and Colin's right. just going to scoop it up there. All right, quick, another quick 2-0 there, man. A lot of quick 2-0s on Standard this week.
Yeah, no, a ton. We'll be back for, what, round 4?
Round 4.